How do I eject my USB if, quote unquote, the device is currently in use? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question that I have heard many times. I have some external hard drives that Windows 11 does not eject properly. This pop-up appears when nothing else is using it. This device is in use. Close any programs that are using the device, then try again. So the frustrating part about this is it's not wrong, right? There is something using the device. It's just not you. And it's also just not obvious. So we need to dig a little bit deeper. Let me show you what I do when I'm faced with this error. First off, here's an example of the error on the screen. I can't show it to you because I don't have a situation where I can make this happen in my virtual machine. I'm going to simulate with something else, but you'll get the idea. This is the error message. The device is currently in use. Close any programs or windows that might be using the same device, then try again. Unfortunately, there's nothing you can close. You're not using the device. And yet Windows claims it's in use. Then it is. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with some tools from the SysInternals toolkit. If you haven't installed, you'll find it, actually it's the SysInternals suite, you'll find it in the Microsoft Store. I already have it installed, but I do recommend that you do so. You'll get, I don't know, probably about a dozen different programs. We're only going to use one of those programs to make this happen, but the other ones tend to come in handy for a variety of uses, so I recommend installing them all. With them installed, then, we're going to run Process Explorer. Now, it may or may not be on your menu. It probably will be here in the All menu if we go down to SysInternal Suite. There's a list of some of the other things that have been installed. What we're looking for is Process Explorer, not Process Monitor, Process Explorer. We'll go ahead and run it. Then the first thing I want you to do before we go any further is to, on the File menu, show details for all processes. What this boils down to is it reruns the program with administrative privileges so that it has access to everything on the machine. So, now, I'm going to assume that you know the drive letter of the drive you're trying to eject or remove. Remember that drive letter. On the Find menu, we're going to click on Find Handle or DLL. What we're going to enter as the handle or DLL substring is your drive letter followed by colon. Now, in my case, I'm simulating my D drive being an external drive that I can't eject for some reason. And we'll just hit enter and let it search. Now, it is going to find some things relatively quickly, but I do need to point out that it's not done. All indications to the contrary, the search continues. And it's not until the search button that we clicked on originally becomes active again, or the edit field where we typed in our D colon becomes active again, that the search is complete. So we're gonna let this complete for however long it takes. And finally, we're done. This took at least a full minute, maybe a minute and a half on this particular machine. So give it time. But again, the telltale that it's done is that the search button is clickable again and the edit field is editable again. You'll notice now that there are several things in this list. These are all things that are referencing the string D colon, which basically means they're probably referencing the drive that you're trying to eject. Now, in my case, you can see here, I've got cmd.exe with D colon backslash and D colon backslash files. That's the red herring. That's the one that I created. You'll see that I've got command running here, and I've actually got it set up in such a way that the D drive is the current drive, and it's trying to write to a file on the D drive. So indeed, command.exe has this drive in use. This is an example of one of those situations where you might have forgotten that, in fact, you did run a program that is still trying to access that external drive. And this, of course, would be the way that you could identify it quickly. I'll go ahead and close that, and that's what you would do. You would close or otherwise change the program that you discovered so that it does not actively access that drive anymore. Now, you don't need to redo the search. We could just run with the search results we have here because there are some interesting things here. There are some frustrating things here. So service hosts, we have three separate service hosts here. They're actually all the same process. And if I click on it, you can see that it's this one, servicehost.exe. If you take a look at the description, the pop-up description of that specific instance of service host, you'll see that it talks about the distributed link tracking client. Whatever. I don't know, nor do I care what it is. All I know is that it is accessing my drive. There's not really much I can do about it. Similarly, the ones above reference the system. This is actually Windows itself is doing things on this drive. Now, in this case, I know what these are. These $extend folders on the D drive are an artifact of it being formatted NTFS. And this is how the NTFS file system contains and maintains some of the metadata that it uses to manage how files are stored on that drive. But once again, it's the system. I have no way of telling the system not to do that. Something not shown here and relatively common are search indexer and your security software. The search indexer may be scanning the contents of that drive in order to update the index that it may use when you perform a search in Windows. That's an easy one. You can just wait for that to be finished. That usually doesn't take all that long. In that same vein, your anti-malware tool, or in the case of Windows itself, Microsoft Security or Windows Defender, may also be doing a periodic scan of that drive, or maybe something changed recently on that drive. Once again, the simplest thing to do is just to wait to let those two finish whatever it is they're doing before you move on. Now, how about those items, like we have here, for which we have no action we can take? They just exist, and there's no way for us to make them not exist. Well, there are two schools of thought on this. The always safe, always correct, and most annoying solution is to shut down your machine, disconnect the drive, and start your machine up again. By definition, shutting down the machine will cause it to stop accessing anything on all the drives, and they are at that point safe to remove. I find that incredibly impractical, especially if it's something that happens frequently. So, the other approach, the pragmatic approach, is to do what you can to make sure that there isn't something you didn't think of accessing the drive that you do have control over. And once you're certain that there is nothing in your control, unplug the drive. Anyway. Here's the thing. In Windows 10, they made a change that dramatically decreases the potential for harm of doing that. Got an article on that. It has to do with how Windows 10 buffers writes. In the past, for speed, writes would get buffered. In other words, a program would write something to the disk and it wouldn't get written immediately. It would get written as it could because the drive was slow enough and you wanted to move on with your things. Nowadays, drives are more than fast enough, so there's really no reason for that buffering. So instead, when you write something to the disk, it gets written to the disk right then and there, which means that as long as you're not actively writing a bunch of stuff to the drive, it's going to be relatively safe to unplug the drive anyway. Now, that being said, there are no absolutes. 100% doesn't exist in computing. So I do recommend that you make sure there's nothing on that USB drive that would be harmful if lost. In other words, back up. Make sure you have a backup. Now, I will tell you, personally, What I do, I will try to safely remove or eject the drive. If it fails, I'll do a quick look to see what might be on the drive that I just forgot that I had open. But if there's nothing, I pull the plug. I just pull the plug and get on with my life, because that is ultimately the most pragmatic solution. Like I said, there aren't any guarantees, but honestly, it's difficult to go wrong these days when you pull the plug on an external drive. Take the steps to ensure that the remove can happen, or that the odds are greatly in your favor if it can't. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/178694. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.